Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Check out the new box I just designed. It is the ultimate box with a lid. And it opens up and it can house $6 worth of quarters. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, we're going to use a dollar. But if you don't have a dollar, you could use a 3x7 rectangle. And for the tutorial for how to make two 3x7 rectangles from a square, click here. Alright, so the first step for this is that we have to divide this into thirds. So here's how you can do it. Let's fold this up and just estimate thirds. So you want to estimate that this is equal to this. And once you get that, you're not going to actually flatten right here. You're going to fold this behind right here. And you want to line up these edges and fiddle with the folds until they're thirds. So you just have to sort of push them back and forth until they line up and lay on top of each other in three equal sections, just like that. And once they're even, you just flatten them, and we have divided this side into thirds. Now let's do the same thing on this side. So the same sort of thing. You want to make this S or Z, I guess, structure, and just fiddle with the folds, push them around until it's thirds. And once it's thirds, then flatten it, and voila, we have thirds here. All right, so now what we're going to do is take this edge, these corners, and fold them right up to these crease marks. Like this, and like that. Okay, and flatten all the way across. Okay, and turn over top to bottom, and now fold this edge up to the top. Okay, now let's unfold and unfold and rotate, and now let's fold this edge up to this crease. So we're just reversing the crease. So now these are both valley folds. Okay, now let's rotate and let's fold this edge up to this edge, and we're just going to fold from the corner. So pinch the corner right when the edges line up. From the corner right to this crease right here, to here. There's a horizontal crease, you can't really see it because of the dollar bill pattern, but you know it's there. Okay, and unfold. And now we're going to fold this edge to this edge, and once again, we're just going to fold from the corner right to this crease. And now let's fold this edge up, and we're going to fold it right on the intersection between the two creases. So here's the diagonal crease and here's the vertical crease. Right at that point, that's where we fold. And the same thing on this side. So it's just right like that, and make sure that these edges are even and flat. Okay, and unfold. And now let's rotate, and let's do the same thing on this side. So let's fold this edge to here, and just fold from here to the crease, and unfold and fold this edge to this edge, and fold from the corner to the crease. Okay. Fold, and now fold up right on the intersection of the creases. Like this. Okay, and so now we have both of always folded like that. Fold it if you haven't. All right, and now let's unfold this, and we're going to fold this one up just short of this edge. So it's about a millimeter short of this edge. And crease it. This rectangle here is going to be the bottom, the inside part of the box, the main box part. And that's why we want it a little bit shorter. And let's unfold. And let's refold this flap. And let's rotate. And let's unfold this flap. And let's fold it up. And this time, we're going to fold a little bit past this line. So about a millimeter past. So line it up, just turn it over, and make this a little bit past the edge, about a millimeter. Okay, and once it's there, flatten. Okay. And this right here is going to be the top of the box. So that's why we want it a little bit larger than the bottom of the box. Okay, and unfold here and rotate. And now we're going to work on the bottom of the box, otherwise known as the eagle side. And this is what we're going to do. We are going to fold this edge right up to this diagonal right here. So pinch along this crease, and you want to bring it up to the diagonal. And also pinch this crease and bring it up to the diagonal. So you're bringing the two edges together right onto the diagonal. And it's right like that. And from the inside, this is what it should look like. This should come to a point there. And when it looks good, flatten it. Okay? And now fold this flap over the edge like that. Okay? And make a little pinch. And here is one of the locks, the corners of the box. Now let's do the same thing on this part. So let's make these two creases and bring them together right onto this diagonal crease. And when they're lined up, flatten like this. And wrap the corner around like that. And pinch. So there is the front of the bottom of the box. Okay, now what we're going to do is turn over and let's form this fold right here and this fold. And we're going to take this edge and we're going to bring it up to this edge, right like that. And when it's touching, then flatten right here. Flatten this whole part, and you see we just made this crease right in between the two edges, like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. So let's fold this edge to this crease and flatten. We just made this diagonal fold right there. Okay. And okay. Now what we're going to do is fold this down like this and fold this down and flatten it. So here we have the main box, and this is going to be the lid. So, here we go. What we're going to do is rotate, and let's fold this edge up, and we're folding it up so that the edge hits this point right here, okay? And the fold should terminate right where this crease right here meets this edge. So right there is where the fold should hit, right at that intersection point. And you want to make sure that this edge goes right onto this point right there. And once it looks good, make a nice sharp crease like that. Okay, and now we're going to do the same thing with this flap. So let's pull it up and put it on top. And now let's fold it so that the edge hits that point and it terminates right at this point right here. Okay, and when it looks good, crease it. Okay, and now let's turn over. And now we're going to fold, make a mountain fold right on this line, but on the layer right here. So just pinch right along that layer, like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. So just line it up and pinch it. And it should come right to this intersection point. Like that, and same thing here, right to the intersection point. And just forming it right on this side, okay? And now let's turn over and let's fold this down and just crease right on the existing fold from this point to this point. Like that. And now let's fold right on our fold that we just made, this right along this box. And keeping this edge down, we're going to fold this like that. Now, what we want to do is we want to slide this corner up so that it meets this edge. So it's right like that. And the purpose of this is that we want this to be 90 degrees. So we're lining it up with this, which we know is 90 degrees. So once it's 90 degrees, it lines up. And we flatten. Okay, and now let's do the same thing on this side. So we unfold here and we fold right like this, folding right on this crease that we made. And now we want to line this edge up right here. So notice, it doesn't line up. We have to pull this corner up so that the edges line up. And flatten. Okay, so here we have this side of the lid, and we have this side of the lid. Now what we have to do is bring up the front of the lid. So the front of the lid is this square right here. So, let's make the mountain fold of the front of the lid right here and on the right side, the mountain fold. And we're going to squeeze these two edges together like this. And we're going to squeeze these two edges. So here we have the side of the lid and the front of the lid and the side of the lid. So it's just like this. And we squeeze them together like this, and squeeze these edges together like this. Okay? And now these flaps, let's bring them up against the front of the lid. So there and there. Okay, now what we're going to do is take this flap and we're going to fold it up. So it's going to cover this flap right here. Just wraps right around there, like that. And let's do the same thing on the left side. So just take this flap and fold it up right like that. And now let's fold on this existing crease like that. And same thing on this side. And just now shape the box. And we are done. And it should close right over like that. Let's make this crease nice. And this comes down like this. And it closes. And so this rectangle should be slightly bigger than this one, which allows the lid to go down nicely. There you have it. And if you want, you can exercise this hinge right here to make it open and close a little bit easier. And it's nice that George Washington is right here. You can just put the box up like this. And put your treasures in here. And then just like that. And voila, there it is. Maybe a hippo box. The hippo dollar bill quarter eater. Hungry hippo. Okay. So, all right. Well, hope you guys enjoyed folding that. And here we go. Bye-bye.